How are you all today? I hope you're doing well. Well, there's so many things going on. I hope you all had a good Super Bowl party for those in the States. Sad stuff, you know, but Seahawks slaughtered them. Wow, I think, holy crap, they were good. They were tight. They weren't about to let that ball go. It was amazing. But, man, I hope you're all doing well. You know, so many of you are getting your remedy like you're supposed to because you're doing the hard work. And I want each and every one of you to pat yourselves on the back. Not ego, but you've done a good job. You guys have done a very good job on yourselves. Don't beat yourselves up. You know, I had a bat with some nails in it hanging over my head. So I drove myself and drove myself. And sometimes I think that's important to do, is that you get lost in Wellville. You just, everything you do, you're doing for your wellness of your bodies and the awakening of yourself. There is nothing any higher that you can do in your journey anywhere in creation that directly affects you and your experience. No matter what that experience is, it's the health of the bodies that you are using and the awareness that you have behind those bodies and how you learn to use them and not be controlled by them. Thought is a very difficult time sometimes to break, the thinking process. But remember, we talked about that in the last video, from the Bible and the serpent of the tree of knowledge all the way to Jay Krishnamurti and think on these things and that whole understanding of go beyond the conditioned mind because truth cannot be experienced in a conditioned state. These sort of understandings are important in your journey to breaking that hold of thinking and thought. And then the hold of desire, becoming desireless. You know, there's nothing wrong with buying things and getting things. But if you, you know, one walk over into different parts of Africa or Indonesia or in different parts of the world, and you start to realize how much excess materiality Americans have. We throw so much away in the dump that it's amazing that, you know, some countries don't even have a fraction of our dumps. Sad stuff, you know, but I think it's, of course, it's all karma generated. Every level has to exist at different levels to have such a wide variety of experiences. You know, when everybody dresses the same, looks the same, talks the same, nothing's very much fun, you know, and there's that consciousness out there that would like that. You know, that social consciousness of socialism, you know, everybody goes, gets up at the same time, kisses the baby at the same time, that sort of crap. I mean, that's not creation. That's not God. That's the negative forces, and that's control. And we don't want that. I was going through some stuff this morning, and I came across these. Can't remember who did them, but I thought this was pretty good. Let me see if the name is here. But I thought this was cute. I don't know. I think you've seen them. It says, "You mean to tell me all I had to do was move my lymph?" Remember those? That was really cute, I thought. And then here, I mean, really, do people think you poop in your kitchen? Now, that one was really good, where it showed the medical doctors walking down the hall. I thought that was pretty cute. This one is kind of cute. "Why, you don't understand food good for you, Dr. Mercola." "You could use some hair, Dr. Mercola." "The hair comes off by what system?" "Move the lymph, Dr. Mercola." "Who has the three lung teeth?" This one is a cute one because I spent time in these areas. And I thought this was real cute. Wait, where's the three lung teeth? Cute. Yeah, you guys are creative as all get out. I love the young minds. You guys are so sharp. Okay. This is from Johny Walker. Johny Walker. "Hi, Dr. Morris. I have been watching your YouTube videos in hope to find an answer to my cardiac neuroses." Not necroses, neuroses. "And it seems as if there is none on that topic." Oh, I thought I would help you out, Johny Walker. Please, it is not asking too much. Make a video or include me in your question and answers. You betcha, my friend. I wonder what herbs I can take to heal this. I have been raw for 4 months straight, I think is what that is. Just fruits. It is not helping, even though I have lymph segment in my urine. Good deal. And my lymph is not that bad. Okay, so let's think about this, because this one is not necessarily the lymph system. I took a national boards one time, and it took me several years to study for it. And it was a cardiac test, a national boards, and it was very involved. I had to know all about EEGs, EKGs, ultrasounds. I had to know all the cardiac meds, advanced life support. I mean, it just went on and on and on. So it was, you had to know all your rhythms, of course. You had to know how to intubate. You had to know all those things. And I have never heard of cardiac neurosis. And I think it's funny, because it's easy to understand that. And he goes on, I mean, I thought he went on in another area about this, but think about the heart. We've talked about the heart before, and somewhere someone was relating this, or he was relating this to anxieties and stuff. It's enough to say that. Think about that. You know, whenever you're dealing in any neurological or emotional event, and emotional is neurological. So whenever you're dealing with an emotional event, and you see a reflex of that emotional event, what gland would you automatically go to when you understand that, one, the central nervous system is the hard drive, and then you have the worker nervous system, which has two parts to it, parasympathetic, sympathetic, push-pull, in-out, breathing, everything is controlled by this autonomic. Autonomic means that it's going to help you move, breathe, heart pump, everything else. So, which nervous system do you think is involved in cardiac neurosis? That's what I thought you'd say. And that is the sympathetic, parasympathetic, the autonomic. Well, now, what glands control the autonomic nervous system, and those same glands are directly responsible for emotional issues, stress issues, inferiority, all these problems we have emotionally. What two glands affect those, and what do they sit on top of? And I knew you were going to say that, because you guys are good. Definitely the adrenal gland sitting on top of the kidney. So you can have a lymphatic issue with that, but this is more a neurological issue, Johny. And this is going right to your adrenal glands and the autonomic nervous system. And I'll tell you also, though, now think about this, guys. Where else would you look for this problem? Where is the second brain? Where is that brain of the autonomic nervous system? You're right. Stomach, solar plexus. So this person, Johny, could have a highly inflamed stomach, small intestine area, from what? Lymphatic constipation, interstitial lymphatic constipation. So this is going back to the adrenals again, the kidneys. See how we keep drawing these similar lines back? So we're back to the kidneys and adrenals again. But we also see how it affected the GI tract and the lymphatic system in the GI tract. So, and again, think about when you go after somebody, you're going always after the kidney and adrenals, always. No, not even a question, always. What else are we always going after? The GI tract, the mouth to you know where. This whole, but we're cleaning, but we're also going after that in a unique way. How are we going after the GI tract by going through kidneys and adrenals, the lymphatic system, interstitial? So we're going after the lymph system in the heart, in the GI tract, in the liver, in the pancreas, in the brain, aren't we? When we go after the kidneys and adrenals in the lymph system, we're going after that individual from head to toe. So we know, if we go back, that if you have a cardiac event, whether it's an emotionally tight or whatever, you're going to go to two places. You're going to go to kidney and adrenals, number one, and then you're going to go to the GI tract, number two, and you're going to get all this inflammation out of there. Because the more that you can feel your stomach, the more you can feel cardiac events tied to that. And so you've got to clean that out. Another thing, clean your lungs out as well. So you're cleaning this body out and you're rebuilding it. So all this inflammation, all the weaknesses in the nervous system. So I would think about more brain and nerve. I would think about the adrenal 400s, probably glandulars, and go into that. Definitely get my kidneys, get my lymph moving, and strengthen up that autonomic nervous system, and you'll pull away from this cardiac neuroses. I thought that was interesting, Johny, that you brought that up, because you don't hear about that too much. Easy to understand when you understand which, that is a neurological event in which nervous system deals with this, and where does that event start? Adrenals, you also have the brain there at the stomach solar plexus area. So when you have a weakness, which is common to have autonomic nerve weakness in today, chronically so. So it's easy to understand, Johny, where this is coming from. Just strengthen up that nervous system, and if you have any heart weakness itself, but getting the lymph out of the heart, also, you know, moving well out of the heart, getting the heart reduced down, getting all this inflammation out of there, of course, increases neurological events, proper neurological rhythms from the sinus node. So I think that is, hopefully I'll help you there, Johny. And this is Donnie. Hey, Dr. Morris, my name is Amon. I am a 25-year-old male with active lifestyle. Hey, Amon. I respect your work. Oh, thanks, man. And herbal medicine and stuff. Yeah, I love herbs. We were working on some things today with herbs, and I just love herbs so much. That's our candy store, guys. That's our nectar. That's our candy store. I think the FDA and medical doctor, everybody needs to turn their head and go, thank you, God. Sorry we were such assholes, and thank you. We do now respect you and your herbs, and now we're going to learn about them and how we can use them. Yeah, right. I consistently have to cough up mucus from my throat. Now look at this. He constantly has to cough up mucus from his throat. So you know he's loaded. You know, he's loaded in the bronchi, loaded in the probably interstitially, loaded in the voice box, loaded in the sinuses and stuff like this. So it's always going to come out. Now, if you got a lot of mucus coming out, what foods would you not want to do? Correct. Dairy products. You wouldn't want to do any dairy products. Get rid of the proteins. Get rid of the grains. Very mucus-forming grains. We got gluten and all this. Get rid of all this kind of crap out of your diet, obviously. Start detoxing, getting this mucus out. Now, if he's already getting mucus out and he goes into this deeper detox, is he going to get a lot more? Could he go into a cold and flu-like symptom? You absolutely could go into a cold and flu-like symptom. Matter of fact, have fun with one, man. I hope you get one. Why? Because you're going to detox so much more out during a cold and flu-like symptom. Matter of fact, welcome the winter for the cold and flus. You know, the medical people, I think it's so funny. You got to laugh at the FDA and the CDC centers and, oh, it's a flu system. People are dying from all these cold and flus and stuff like this. And it's just such a dramatic event. And it's all hyped up for nothing. You know, they're obvious. You all understand cold and flus and why the mucus and why all this and why the cold and the flu in the first place. You know, the acidosis, the heavy lymph, the heavy congestion in the human body, cold as alkaline, cold starts detoxification. Yeah, great. They need to understand that and stop killing people with cold and flu-like symptoms in the treatment of that. If anybody dies from a cold and flu-like symptom, holy crap, they weren't treated right. Because no one dies from those or pneumonias or things like that treated properly and not treated, meaning treated like medical doctors, and not diseases like pneumonia-like disease type thinking. You know, I don't know that you have to walk on eggshells anymore. I think we, you know, this is all coming to a head. Bonfire coming. Bonfire. Okay, I constantly have a cough up mucus from my throat whenever I finish eating and have clogged sinuses whenever I eat certain foods. No kidding. And has been a nightmare for the past year. I believe I am lactose intolerant. Everybody is. And try to remove all dairy products out of my diet sooner than later, right? Amon, cannot stop this constant phlegm. Well, it's got to come out now. Remember, through the years of being in your mother, and then however old you are, you're 25-year-old male, you've had all these years of either mother's milk or formulas in the beginning, cow's milk, whatever they decided to give you in that way. Then you had your mother's congestion when you were hooked to her lymphatically. So then you come out with the milks or the formulas or whatever, and it's just a nightmare. It's just, and the cheeses and everything. It's a nightmare. It's a friggin' nightmare out there. So when you have that much phlegm, you're full of it, basically. Meaning you've got to let this come out, man. You've got to let this drain out. So get prepared for a cold and flu-like symptom or bronchitis or pneumonia or whatever, and good. You know, if you have any problems, you guys, you got a Facebook site, and then you've got this clinic here to help you. And there's clinics starting. All these Facebook beautiful souls on YouTube are opening up healing centers around the world, detox spas. I'm proud of all of you guys. We're making employments, but we're making an employment that can help the world get their health together. I feel so blessed that you guys are coming along with us. This is just a beautiful thing. I've been trying to get out of... I have been trying to cut out dairy foods from my diet for a few months now and have clogged sinuses and has stopped me from breathing properly and more vulnerable to cold and flu-like symptoms. Well, you need one. Have a good one on me, man. You'll breathe better, smell better, taste better after you have it. You know, they're always good afterwards. You don't feel so good. Well, quit putting it in. You know, but they don't tell you that. You know, so we wake up going, what's all this mucus coming out of me? And no one's sitting there to help you. That's the beauty of you guys. In the future, something your mom, your dad's going to go, oh, that's from all the milk I gave you. And I'm going to clean it out. Hopefully in the future, these babies won't have any of that. Notice babies born from raw mothers don't have all the mucus when they're born. And also they don't have all the lymphatic problems. I mean, this really is so important for the children. I thought I'd never say that. I also noticed that I am sweaty heavily without doing any exercise or movement. Okay, so what do you think, guys? Amon here sweats a lot, even though he does nothing. I mean, you know, he's sedentary. He doesn't get out and work out to sweat. What would be your take on that? What would be his problem? Right off. Absolutely. Kidneys, not filtering. So who's doing the filtering? The skin. You know, Amon, that means your kidneys are, and you're only 25, so you know you have kidneys. So you got to fix these. Get the adrenals up, my friend. Get the kidneys filtering, and then that sweating will reside down. At least you know your thyroid's good enough to give yourself a good sweat. You know, when you don't sweat either, that's double trouble, double jeopardy, meaning your thyroid isn't giving you the body temperature to sweat too. So this is just telling you you're loaded with mucus, your kidneys aren't filtering your lymph system well, so it's coming out all your holes, and then and even your skin is trying to make up for what your kidneys can't do. So your body's begging you and telling you, let me go, let me have a cold and flu-like symptom, let me clean myself out. At the same time, get those kidneys filtering and the adrenals up, man. I could walk to my local grocery store and be sweating heavily, which I cannot. That shows big-time kidneys. Big-time kidneys. The fact you're sweating, thank God for that, man, even though it's probably not desirable, but for a while. Once you get the kidneys filtering, that sweating will back off, and you'll be doing really good. And you'll get all this mucus out of you. Heavy, which I cannot bear, while the trips of my toes and fingers are cold as ice, even on a hot day when it's been going on for the past 4 months. That's scary. Your tips of your fingers are cold. You know what? You really need to move your lymph and get your circulation moving, get your lymph moving. I would do lower circulation too on this case. I also would get this lymph moving. Check the basal temperatures. Obviously, they're enough to get heavy sweating, but they might not be enough to keep him warm. So you just have to check that. Check all the glands. Check everything. Detox this kid. I would really appreciate your guidance. Absolutely. I'll tell you what, Amon. You want to get go after that detox. Go the 2-week kit, that'll deworm you, it'll just start opening the doors. Then from there on, all the kits have 2 kidneys, 2 lymphatics. We're honking, we're moving, we're opening some doors here, baby. And that's why you have to get yourself on fruits, start expectorating, start pulling this mucus out. And yaha, let this mucus come out. Probably full of it. you know, as most of us are, full of friggin' ass mucus. And it's just, you know, read Arnold Errett's work and stuff on the mucus diet healing system and stuff, and you'll see. But it's easy to understand mucus. We all get it. It comes from the mucosa, which the body's lined with it, and it's just a protectant. It's a lipid-based, cholesterol-based. It's protective against acids and proteins. So when you start consuming proteins that create mucus, that's when you back away. Whoa, whoa, whoa. If it's creating it immediately where I can see it, what is it doing in my body when I can't see it? You know? And is this mucus building up in other places besides where I can perceive that? Sinuses, bronchi, lungs. How about in the liver? How about in the bowels? And how? Absolutely. It's why you guys see so much mucus coming out of your bodies when you start detoxifying from the stool. And in the urine, matter of fact, full body detox, mucus out of every hole, out of every eliminative organ. And it just shows you that we're eating wrong foods. I mean, it's just another little clip to show you that the foods we eat, the body doesn't want them. Whenever you get mucus that bad from a food, your body's going, no way, Jose. Dr. Morse, I would really appreciate your opinion of the Carey Reams biological theory of ionization. Carey Reams is a contemporary of Bernard Jensen. Well, I can't speak to that. Bernard Jensen was a personal friend, and I knew Carey Reams as well. Matter of fact, I did Carey Reams' program for probably 2 years here. I started out doing Reams, and I did blood work, and I did hair analysis, and, trying to look at body chemistry and understand oxidation and ionization and the whole nine yards. And as you keep studying, you'll really start to understand things, that there's a lot of theories out there, as Reams was a theory. Carey Reams, a contemporary of Bernard Jensen, I don't know about that. You know, I believe he had a clinic in Florida, which he did, then Georgia, and spent time in jail for helping people cure themselves. That's not really why. I read the case. I have a federal prosecutor, a friend of mine, and he pulled the case for me and showed me the case. There were some problems because there was a lady that died in his clinic, and she had type 1 diabetes, and she died on him. Well, when the paramedics got there, they made a comment to law enforcement that he was reading a newspaper with his feet up on his desk, and he could have cared less, the body's in there. So, I mean, that's what I read. So I don't know, you know, I don't know about that sort of thing. I can tell you that 60 Minutes did a special on Carey Reams, which is your analysis. And what they did with him is they got about 4 guys to pee in a jar. And then they took the jar to Carey, and he analyzed it, of course. And then they took that analyzation, they took it to a medical doctor. Now, this is 60 Minutes, and I lost respect for 60 Minutes with the Carey Reams special they did, because they themselves made themselves look stupid. First of all, you could have 10 people pee in a cup. You're still going to get because of the law of homeostasis and the like, you're always going to get a chemical print out of that. You will always do that. So I thought that was ridiculous for them to do that in the first place, because there's no way he could have known that there was several urines mixed in one through chemistry. I thought that was stupid of 60 Minutes. And the other thing that was so stupid is they took Carey Reams' chemical analysis and his theories on ionization and all that, and the test results, and they took it to this fat medical doctor. And they showed this to this fat medical doctor, and I forget, Wally Safer or one of them, said to this medical doctor, "What does these numbers mean to you?" I just lost all respect. I've seen shows that 60 Minutes did I thought was really up there good. This one was a nightmare. It was just wasn't even factual. And for an organization that supposedly seeks out truth, I thought they did this a really bad disjustice, because if you want to seek truth, you would do that totally different story. They were definitely out to slander him and to cut him down. Because, and of course, there's no medical doctor. Unless you're a biochemist and a chemist, are you going to understand the theories of ionization and oxidation and the like? You're not going to understand that. And if you don't have a little physics in your background, that's going to even be harder for medical doctors to understand. And then, I thought it was a wrong thing to do to a medical doctor, first of all. But for this medical doctor to comment showed narcissism, because he said nothing. That means nothing. He should have said, I don't know. I'm not a chemist. I'm not a biochemist. I don't understand some of these deeper theories. He would have been factual and honest and made himself look pretty good. But instead, he made himself look like a butt, and it just made 60 Minutes look bad, because no one's going to understand a scientist's theories. My theories are my theories. Now, I open the door in every way and show you guys and experience, except in these advanced levels of biochemistry, because it's theory time. And maybe someday I'll do a whole video and we will open up this door of biochemistry, ionization, oxidation, this whole crib site, this whole thing maybe someday, and show you where we get to a point where everything's theories and where some of the theories are obviously flawed. So it's just all of this, and it's how you perceive, again, going back to the tree of knowledge, the mind, the conditioned state. I mean, that's all we're looking at is people's theories and ideas of how God did it. The fact that it already is a biosphere is out there, and that the different vertebrates, the different diets, we don't have to go to theories and play in that world to try to find a cure for diseases when all of this is illusionary. All of that's just all made up stuff. You know, we're spiritual people. We're the God people. We come with the facts, the truth. We come with all of this. And you don't have to have other a world of people's own theories, because we're the God people. We come with the awareness from the Godhead itself. We come from that awareness. So it shows you deeper how things are done, more simplistically. Yes, he saw the human body as a terrain, the soil. He was heavy into the sugars, of course, in the urine and being able to tell the byproducts, but still nothing like where you guys are. And sometimes when you get into some of these things, I use all the different issues with him. I still have my little sugar analyzer. I still have all of this, but you know what? Never got us anywhere, never got anybody healthy. I'm going to tell you, some of this stuff you got to kind of be careful with. And Carey Reams is one of them. Same thing. I know a lot of people that there's an educator up here on Carey Reams too in the past, and none of these people did anything miraculous. I'm the only one locally that's still around curing up people right and left. All these other people went out of business and died off and everything else because they couldn't get the remedy for the people with these sort of theories. This was accomplished by analyzing the urine, saliva for pH, nitric content, sugar content, dissolved solids. Nah, did it all, man. Did it all. Oh, this is Dr. Paula. Hey, I did it all. You know, I did all that. I worked hard. I'm trying to figure out, trying to open this crossword or this jigsaw puzzle up, you know, to see all the pieces and how they connect. Because I got one of those minds that I got to see that whole, I got to see all the pieces fit in the right, and they all have to fit. For truth to be truth, everything has to fit real tight, real good, and everything relate to another, and everything flow that way. Doesn't always do that in chemistry or biochemistry, because there's so many factors, so many chemical interchanges and biological transmutations and things going on, that it can be a real tree of knowledge issue. And as many years and as knowledge and the bodies from that we have from China and all the physiology and all the anatomy, we still don't know it. All the physics, all the chemistry, we still don't know. And then partly because those people that are involved lack the spirituality, a lot of them. And so you have people like Monsanto. You know, if those people were more spiritual people, their Monsanto wouldn't exist. They wouldn't be trying to create GMOs. They would be trying to strengthen instead of weaken the strains. And I see that their whole consciousness is out there wrong. As an old farm girl myself, oh, this appears totally logical, and I would really appreciate your opinion. Well, I mean, they're bits and pieces. I think, Doc, you're really seeing pieces of it. There's pieces of truth in everything. There's no question about that. I'm not denying that. Everybody has a piece of the rock. Pieces, pieces, pieces. I think it's up to us to put these pieces together, but simplistically enough where the average person can find their remedy. And I think that's what we're doing, because when you try to use all these factors, and it's been so many years ago, I can't even remember. I got these books here and everything else on it still, but I can't even remember. It's been, I mean, this was back in the early 70s I did this. So that was the problem there. But still, our way is so much simpler, and it doesn't matter what the theories of biochemistry is, because if you keep the simplistic understanding of energetics, consciousness, or intelligence, and your two sides of chemistry at least, and basically the nature of acids versus the nature of base or alkalis, and understand that keeping that simple, you can give people their remedy. You won't be talking over their heads. People will have a good life. And for those that want to get academically inclined, have at it. But just keep in mind that sometimes you waste a lot of years studying on stuff that doesn't give you any closer to truth. And that's the problem. Sometimes you can spend years thinking you're on the right path and doing everything right, and suddenly you realize, oops. So I think life is much simpler than to break into this world of theories and things of chemistry and overlooking the simplistic, Doc. I think the simplistic is so much better. And I tell you, as soon as I let the reams go, and I still do hair analysis once in a while, only for toxic metal or heavy metal look, because it doesn't matter what your hair analysis come out and shows. You can't judge any of mineral imbalances until you, one, detox all the free radical minerals and everything out till you fix digestion, absorption, utilization with the glands. Unless you fix the adrenals and you have complete mineral utilization from your mineral cortical steroids, you can't judge zinc, selenium deficiencies. You can't judge any of these things, because you have to take in consideration malabsorption when you're looking at chemical interactions or ionization. You also have to take in the factors of chemistry and how that is, factors of digestion, factors of transmutations, and it's like, oh. So you can get so complicated. That's what happened to me. I tore it all apart, and I'm going, some of these pieces don't fit back together. So I put them back the way I felt they would fit the best for the simplicity of mankind. And this is just, I think this is the best way to keep practitioners happy, yourself happy, and keep yourself having a life instead of trying to find the little inlets and outlets of chemistry, because it's just impossible. So many cofactors. And then you have the cofactors of stress, the cofactors of adrenals and steroids, and how that affects mineral utilization or ionization. I mean, you've got all these factors of activity, genetic weaknesses, absorption, digestion. I mean, we could go on all day long. That's why I think our approach is simplistic, but it's to on point, it's on truth, it gives, empowers the person, it doesn't breed fear, it breeds strength and control, and I think all these things for practitioners is just what you want out of your clients. You want your clients to gain the knowledge and come in and have a nice rap session with you about truth. Notice if you go in and sit down with a medical doctor and start talking about this, you'll probably get kicked out. You know, I mean, I've got friends that are medical doctors. We like to sit down and talk. But there's others, no, you know, because they don't have the facts and figures. They're working on theories and assumptions. And you can't have good conversations with people that deal with that, because there's no factual, there's nothing to feed the truth part of the intellect. So, Dr. Paula, I think you're right on with that. I will say this, though. Did it, been there, done that one. I've been there and done a lot of that. And it's, you know, we're way on down the road, way on down. He also believed that lemon was the only anionic food out there. Matter of fact, I'm with Dr. Paul. I want to show you a book, and I'll have to bring it because I keep it at home because I revere this. This is from an osteopath, but he was a chemist. And he, medical doctors tried to get into his classes, and he'd only select a few at a time. I think he's passed now. He called his wife because I was going to ask him a few questions. And He said, you've got to come to my class. I want you to come to my class. And I never did make it to his class. But this guy was way out there. And at a point, he was out there further, I think, than Reams. But then he also got wrapped up in some theories. After you get up into the zeta potentials and you get up into these levels, you start getting into some theories like the Horowitz theories and stuff. And so I kind of thought that, you know, there's more knowledge, and it's some, you know, the intellect part of my mind even is like, yeah, this is good, but I'm trying not to, because then that affects my spiritual side, because there goes the mind off on the journey again, and I don't want to follow that journey, because again, all the books you read is from other people's opinions. What about truth? And each and every one of you can see truth if you just quiet that little conversation piece called the mind down and control that. You can see truth more. And they're just, I mean, it just floods into you. And then you start going, I see that. Because you don't need to read it to see it. But, thanks, Doc, for that. I appreciate the question. I was waiting for someone to ask me about Carey Reams. I thought it was too bad, though, that the way he treated that lady that died on him, that girl that died on him. The paramedic didn't have anything good to say about that situation. You can get the court case. You can pull the court case up. Matter of fact, I've got that court case somewhere in here, Doc, if you wanted to read it. But I'd have to go digging, but I do have it. Hi, Doc Morse. Just wanted to give you a massive hug. Oh yeah. Ooh, tighter. Oh, yeah. I like that. Thanks. P-R-A-S. Thanks, man. Trying. I am a 29-year-old male from the UK. With the help of your teachings and herbs, gland formulas, I have fully recovered from, wow, lifelong chronic asthma and eczema. Oh, good, man. Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo! Yeah, baby, you are kicking butt, man. But you know what? Why can't we have our remedies? Why don't we have our, you know, I look around and I see people with confused looks on their faces when you tell them things like this. Well, I didn't know that stuff was curable. You didn't know it was curable? See, I think one of the problem is, guys, is that we have so much medical for so long they can't cure anything. Suddenly nothing's curable and people have lost their hope. And the young people, everybody's lost their hope. They've been to medical doctor after medical doctor. You know, after you pass about three or four of the guys, pretty soon you're losing hope because everyone pretty much says the same thing. Or someone has a different take on it, but it's just a different take on the same spin. So this is good. Good. Five gold stars, man. Five gold stars. I was on daily albuterol inhalers. Wow. And you see, he was listen to this guy, and I have to say, P-R-A-S, Pras? Well, whatever. I have to say, you need a gold star, and not five gold stars today, man. Here's the thing. Inhalers, albuterol, well known as a potential cancer causer, because it's not only as an antispasmodic, it locks the sputum in. Well, when you lock acid mucus into the interstitial layers of the lung, guess what starts to happen? Inflammation, swelling, scar tissue can take place, masses can form. I'm just saying. I mean, all these guys, and they don't understand that there is not just there's the neurological event tied here, and it's tied right down to that autonomic and the adrenal glands. And this is what this guy has done. He's fixed his adrenal glands. He's 29 years old. You know he's going to have adrenals, and of course, there's the asthma to prove it. He's fixing this so he doesn't have COPD. He's cleaning his lymph, so his lungs are cleaning, his skin is cleaning. This guy's done the do. This guy knows how to do it. Now, he's been on steroid creams. Of course, that just slams his adrenal glands. So, my friend, you need to keep working on those adrenals till they're so good you can't stand yourself. But that, you know, they've done everything to cut this guy down, and he won. He turned around and won this. Now, I am no medications at all. Your love and constant reminders that I am more than the physical body and mind got me through some pretty scary healing crisis. I love you, man. You know what? Thanks. I appreciate that. There is some real scary, and he brings up a good point here. There is some scary healing crisis when you're a neurological case, because breathing is nice. Just saying, it's a nice thing to do. And so when you're dealing in difficulties, and especially in the nervous system, that it's a freak thing. It can, because it's an adrenal weakness, because it's a neural weakness, it can also breed major anxieties. You know, when you suddenly difficult breathing and hard to take a deep breath, panic can set in. So this guy's done well. This guy, I'm pretty proud of this guy, because this guy rode those scary things. He took that bull by the horn, and he rode it, and he won. And then each and every one of you can do that too. Some of these healing crises are scary. That's why I say you have to know when to hold them and know when to fold them and know when to play those cards, baby. And you guys played your cards. You're doing well. And I hear this so much. And that's what I mean. And you too, Hilly. You guys stand up and pat yourselves on the back. Not egotistically, but lovingly. Hilly, you too. You've done so much great work on yourself. You were pretty bad off. And so there's a lot of people that they're so loving and humble. But I'm going to tell you, be proud of what you've done. And you can tell other people, I had hands that were bad and now they're getting, I've been to Hellville and now I'm walking out of there. I mean, stand up and be counted, because you can tell people what you've done. Not from an ego, but from, look at what I accomplished, and you can accomplish this too. You know, empowering the people. And I appreciate what this young man has said to me too. And I appreciate that. That we're more than the physical body. And that's things we have to realize. Because someday you will be in the seat and it's your time to beam me up, Scotty. Leave it. Let it go. Ha ha! I'm coming, baby. You know, have fun. You did good. I went 95% raw for 6 months and did high fruit diet. Good thing. I'm glad you did the fruit. That made all the difference in the world on you, man. If you'd have done all vegetables, you probably wouldn't have been so happy. Did the Dr. Morris detox kit 3 times with adrenal glands, and it kicked the butt of all the disease I suffered from. Woohoo! Good job. I am extremely grateful. No, thank you, man. Gotcha. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for that. P-R-A-S. Love you. Good job. Good job. You know? And the nice thing is that people can hear that they're suffering from this too. A lot of the young people have that. You know, it's the adrenals. So you have the asthmas, you have the breathing problems, you have the neurological things going on, you have the seizures. Oh my God, this world is so many problems. Holy crap. You guys, I'm just so proud of you for all that you're doing. This world will probably little note or long remember us, but you know what? We'll be in the history books of making a major conscious change to the lack of awareness on this planet. It's disgusting. And you beautiful souls out there, you're a huge part of this. And be a part of this. Take it on and wear the robe and be the channel of God, each and every one of you, because we all are here together. And we got a lot of spiritual beings working. I don't know how many of you are watching your dreams, but there's a lot of Eckmasters that are good friends, and they're here. We're helping us, and there's a lot of beings on every level right now. There's a lot of spiritual beings. Someday I'm going to bring you a bunch of pictures and show you some of these non-embodied beings. Maybe you'll remember them in your dreams and show you some pictures of some of these guys. But, you know, remember, you've got a spiritual guide. You've got Eckmasters. Call them the Eckmasters. These guys are extremely powerful, very protected. There's so many great spiritual beings out there ready to help. You know, it's just, here's my hand, you know. It's just a beautiful thing. And remember, this is just a little patent place. That's a long time ago soap opera, but this is just a soap opera, just another soap opera in the infiniteness of creation, you know. So there's a time where you deserve to awaken from this and have a grander experience, and that's all those are coming to us. You know, we don't fill up our subscribers like Dan does, but, you know, you guys are the cream of the crops, and that's what's important, is that we have a stability and a strength while all the kids play, but we develop a strength and a knowledge and awareness of how to take a suffering soul and bring them to Wellville. And I'm so proud of each and every one of you. You're driving your own trains into Wellville. Good job. Good job. I wanted to do this video this morning. I don't have much time left, but I just wanted to thank you all. to thank you all for the good job that you're doing on yourselves. And I know it's like this young lad here, you know, going through some scary healing crisis, but he did it. He stood tall, still alive and well today. I mean, this is just to understand that there's some scary moments and there's difficult moments in desire and the body and the pain and all this. It's tough. But there is a Well-Built station, and it's waiting for you guys. It's waiting for each and every one of you. Just keep driving your car into Well-Built. And at the same time, keep you separate from your car. Remember, you're the driver. You're not the car. You know? Let me see. Thank you so much. Oh, thank you. My family and I have learned so much. Oh, that's neat. Everything I've learned myself is because my wife found you in her quest to find her own health and healing. Oh, wow. Which is why I'm writing you today. First, I would like to give you a little bit of history on our specific situation. I am in the Army, and I have been for... Oh, man. So, here we go. Vaccination City. A lot of toxicity there, man. And have been for almost 14 years. Oh, I'm going for it, huh? I have deployed 4 times in the past. Holy grand. You got cojones of steel. You know, in Vietnam, if we signed up for the second tour, it's like, are you crazy? I mean, Vietnam was bad. I mean, they're all bad. You never know when you're going to get blown up. They're all bad. And there was a lot of guys killed. I mean, guys and gals, 56,000. That's a lot of people to die in a war. Young people, you know what? It's a lot of people to die in a war. There's been more, I know, but I'm just saying, I was steeped in that myself, but deployed 4 times. You've got cojones of steel, my friend. And the requirement to be away from my family never slows down. Oh, which has given me my own set of issues dealing with constant stress. No kidding. And you're a hell of a guy, man. And as you can imagine, eating healthy in the Army. Yeah. Now, Air Force, know quite well. The idea of processed and packaged foods was invented by the military to be able to feed the soldier during World War II. Haven't changed much, haven't. And you know what's interesting is that we have dehydrated foods, organic dehydrated foods of all kinds that have all kinds of great meals in packages that you can open right up, same thing, and be better for you. I don't know why they just haven't got into that. And they haven't slowed one bit. Neither has the training. Because of that, we struggle immensely, I bet. I feel sorry for you guys. Oh, my God. This stress is what my main concern is. As the military is slowly being degraded, I find it harder and harder to separate myself and leave the stress on base. That's too bad. I know. I've got my own things. I don't like to... I get beat up if I express too much of that. But so I bring it home every single day. Well, the militaries have always been unique. And I don't know what to say about it. I think that every walk of life has to change the way they feed their people. The military branches, the prisons, the schools. We have such a job to do to infiltrate this, to build strength and endurance in our men and health in our men. Because 4 tours in a war, I mean, I don't know if people know what that is. I mean, look at that guy that 10 tours. I mean, I don't know if people understand what that means in a war. What 10 tours or 4 tours in a war or do to you emotionally, and I don't know if people realize that. In any second, you can have your head blown up, in any second. And you live that way day in and day out. I don't understand, you know, it's a sad thing. It's so sad, that's why I preach love, and let's throw our guns down and hug everybody, and it's just tough. It's a tough world out there. Everybody's eating wrong, and they're so angry, their bodies are so constipated and unhealthy, makes the mind unhealthy, the emotions unhealthy. You see how eating healthy changes everybody, turns them from anger machines to love machines. I don't know, it's so much work to do on this planet, but it's a warring planet, you know. I mean, I don't know what to say about it. This stress and constant being apart has taken its toll on our marriage to the point where there isn't much of a relationship anymore. That's the thing that used to piss me off the most about military. Broke up so many families through the years. It's unbelievable, you know. And especially if you're going for a lifer or something, 15 years, you're definitely going for a lifer, right? I mean, I've got in-laws that are lifers, colonels and stuff, you know. They do some neat stuff. Air Force, mostly. Where there's, that's sad. Isn't that sad? This guy hasn't got much of a relationship left, which creates its own stress, and it all snowballs from there. There are the things I want to, these are the things I want to fix. Well, I have to say this. We have to spiritualize ourselves. Even in the military, we have to develop some detachment. And I don't know, you know, it's just, it's all about understanding that these are just bodies, that this whole thing is already a created universe, that we are just here as visitors playing this game that God has set up. It's not our game. We're learning, of course, it is our game in one way because we are part of that God. We are, you know, so it's just helping to mature us, to develop our ability to be detached in situations. And then when we create our own universes, you don't have all the turmoil that this one has. You have to be careful. You can even see it from yourself, emanating the life force from yourself. You've got positive and negative, and those two start moving around. Get the Tiger's Fang by Paul Twitchell. The Tiger's Fang and the Key to Secret Worlds by Paul Twitchell, and read those. You will be literally amazed at all the God worlds, and you'll come to the part where you'll see what I'm talking about there. This all compounds a deep depression and anxiety issues my wife is battling now. Now remember, let's go back there. The wife, of course, without her man. And I mean, this it's just a nightmare. I just even hate to read this. But with a wife's deep depression, you notice there's some parathyroid going on there. There's some anxiety. Of course, these guys are going to have their adrenals wrecked. So all of them, including yourself, should be on adrenal glandulars, you know, and really build your adrenals up. My wife is bad. It is to the point that she is never relaxed. Well, she's got to get into this and detox herself, get her adrenals up, because, you know, she's worried you'll probably never come home, stuff like that. I mean, this is all a friggin' nightmare. And it's just sad stuff, the whole world. And it's just not American troops. All these other countries have their own troops involved, too. So this affects families and babies and wives and husbands everywhere. It isn't just Americans. And that's a sad thing. It's everywhere. It's just sad. We don't think of much about it. We don't think much that we killed 500,000 Iraqis under George Bush. 500,000. It's been guesstimated we've killed over 500,000 Iraqis, and we ended up with, 3,000-4,000 dead, and they ended up with 500,000 dead? I mean, this stuff's vomitous to me. It's like the third element or whatever with Bruce Willis and the female God. That's how, when I look and see these things, I feel the same way as I can imagine. It is the point, okay, her nerves are always pinging from even the smallest amount of stress. Well, here's the thing. Your wife and both of you just need to get into detoxification, start cleaning the body out, getting your kidneys. You're going to have to all live on adrenal 400s or something, you know, and keep trying to keep those adrenals up. And brain and nerve, a very important formula for everybody here. Upper circulation to keep the brain synapses and everything firing good, keep the brain and nerve for all that going, keeping the myelin sheath strong, keeping the adrenals up. Detachment, learning that you have to love with total detachment. You have to, and that's why the spiritual side, I have to say, with soldiers and stuff, the spiritual side is so important, because this speaks right directly to your survival at emotional and mental levels. Survival is beyond just the physical survival side of this, you know, and just realizing that you're in creation, you're not part of this, you're just in here experiencing. It's a soap opera, it's a war zone, and I don't know what to say about it. You know, wives and husbands are pulled apart. People are pulled apart. I guess it depends of how much connections there. And maybe in some cases, remember, the karma in some cases are also meant to do this to you. I know this sounds crazy, but, you know, our karma we built up. It's possible, my friend, you're with this woman just for a short period of time and you're meant to go in opposite ways. Maybe this needed to pull you to you. I'll give you two views of it. This man's wife could be a soul that's been traveling with him for lifetimes after lifetimes, and he needed to get away from it, from that soul, needed to break that karmic bond. And it took this level to do that. It's possible. You can't judge that. That's the problem with that. Your wife could be one of your, the soul you've dearly loved and traveled with, could have been your father one lifetime, your brother another lifetime, could have been, you know, all different things to you. But this time might be the lifetime to end that, so you could get freedom and she can get freedom from that relationship, so everybody can go on and grow. All right, so that's just one thought of that. The other side of that, football season, cookies. But anyway, you got to realize it can be that way, and it could be that you guys were meant to be together, test your ability to have detachment in your love for each other. I mean, there's always to look at this sort of thing, but you're at the greatest test there ever was. Long time away from someone. It's like the mind. Remember, we're talking about the mind. You look over here, you're gone. I'm looking over here now. My activity is over here. This is going to die away energetically if I don't keep this fed. If you guys don't keep your worlds fed and your healing fed and your happiness fed, it's going to die away on you. So that's why you merge with the all of the all. You quiet that mind and you merge. So there's two ways to look at this, my friend. The spiritual side could be that this is essential for you to gain your freedom. And this freedom goes beyond just a physical freedom. This is your eternal freedom, your ability to shake creation completely so that you go on into some much higher worlds to experience. So there's a reason we have all these things. There's a reason we're brought together and then torn apart. You know, there's a reason for all these things. And I think if you look at God, this is totally already set up. You can't get mad because it's just the way it's designed. You're just a player in the drama. And it's just becoming more awake to that, and then you can become more awake to whether you want to be the player anymore. You can change, and then your drama changes. So there's several ways to look at this, but I say that it's a sad all the way through, you know, that we have this sort of thing going on. But it's a very low planet. It's beautiful in one way, but warring in another. Put it this way, we could all meet in different places, different heavens. I'll use the word heavens, different worlds. As Jesus said, many rooms in my Father's mansion, different worlds and different planets. We could all travel out of body. You would find places that you just, the beauty is so encompassing that ecstasy and joy roll from you, emanate from you, and you forget all about this. This is gone. So it's just crazy that way. But everything is here for you to experience and for your betterment and for your going on to your next journey. So no matter what you got trapped into, that was for you to grow, man. So that I think you just have to realize that you're going to have to grow. I'm ready. I'm going. I'm coming. Let me see here. Reading your book and listening to your videos, we know there are some adrenal parathyroid issues. Yep, good deal. On top of the standard kit, absolutely. So this is going to help your wife a lot. Now, if you guys are met together, you get your adrenals up, everybody's healthy, and that bond comes in there, then great. You know, you just have to roll with it, both of you. Man and woman, sit down and have conversations, spiritual conversations and stuff like that. With kidneys and stagnant lymph in the head and the absolutely. However, I worry that there will not be any real healing as long as the stress is constant. Well, if you can pick up your adrenals enough and build your detachment enough, your stress will end. I know this sounds horrible, but you have to become detached. If you can just not care, give love to everything, but not care about how it ends, because it's always going to end good for you, for her, for everybody. And just live detached. It'll bring you together better. It really will. However, I'm worried that there will be, okay, healing, and you won't be stressful. You'll be in a situation without bringing the stress in the situation. She has been on the Fab Four for a while, as much as our income will allow. Well, at least do the brain and nerve with her as well. Switch around on that. I think you're doing a good job here. Her diet is pretty good, but not as good as it could be. Mornings are usually started with a warm cup of distilled water with fresh lemon juice and a little syrup to sweeten it. The rest of my day is fruit and a salad for dinner. With that, what would you recommend for her to help ease some of this so she can continue to get healthy? Well, I would definitely take maybe our depression formula, or definitely a brain and nerve number 2, maybe the depression formula, just to help get the moonshine yarrow. You know, a lot of you guys got that one. You picked up on the Running Fox Farms that I was talking to you about. You guys know she's such a sweetheart. These are good formulas. You might want to get that, and both of you use that. It's a flower essence. You can use it on the battlefield. I mean, you can use it in the military. Just give you a pump, give you a little junk, you know. I mean, that's really good for keeping that stress away and keeping yourself more conscious and stuff. And these are just flowers. You know, you see flowers and it just kind of changes the mood, that's consciousness, elevates it. And that's what the flower essences do. You know, so emotionally and mentally they help you. So you guys might want to get into the flower essences. I'm coming and work with that. Also, I would like to know about giving a glandular to children. Absolutely, you can. You know, but I would cut it down, you know. If it's a pill, cut the pill in half or a quarter, whatever. If a capsule, open it up and just put a little bit of the capsule in. But you could also use the herbal glandular for that. I mean, the herbs for the adrenal glands. Our son is 11 years old. Of course, you know your son's going to have the wife's parathyroid and adrenals and has been taking herbs for about a year now. Knowing now that my wife and I weren't the healthiest when he was born tells me he may need the same glandular kick. Yeah, I think you're right, too. Yeah. Thank you so much for everything. Oh, thank you. You're the one we need to thank, my friend. 4 tours. Love you, man. Keep it up, guys, and find your ways. I'm here with you always. We'll all work out through them. Work with your spiritual guides and masters, and have fun today. Keep the mind quiet, and if I can and no one shows again, I'll do another video and try to keep on, because you guys, I'm still having a hard time catching up. Hopefully this week I'll have a bunch of no-shows. I mean, I hate to ask for those, but that's how I get with you guys. So I love you guys. You have fun today. It's been a pleasure. Always, always, always love you.